children in India to have exactly what any child who is faced with cancer anywhere in the developed country has. Why should they not?
Most parents have decided to have only one child because they feel that the inputs they need to give to make sure that this child reaches his or her full potential is so great. And when that child gets sick and you don't have that much resources, it's a double whammy. And the family is absolutely devastated.
When a doctor says your child has cancer, it only means my child is dying. Because nobody understands after that chemotherapy, radiation, surgery, this is what you need to do, this test, that test.
I was 14 when I came to know I was affected with leukemia. When my doctors told me that you have leukemia, I was like, I don't want to undergo treatment. I just want to go home and have lots of food for the last time before I die. And they were like, see, listen to us carefully. You undergo the treatment and we assure you, like, you'll live, you'll not die, because leukemia is one of the most curable cancers in the world.
ALL is one of the most common cancers, right? About 45% of all childhood cancer is acute lymphocytic leukemia. And in a country like ours, that's a large number of new cases of childhood cancer relative to the rest of the world.
We are currently researching appropriate therapy for a child with leukemia in India. This is the Icicle Trial, and Professor Vaskar Saha is leading that trial.
Dr. Vaskar Saha came back from UK to India to take up this challenge, to actually look at developing a standard of care protocol.
So when the opportunity first came, I had two options. One was to move to India and leave Manchester, University of Manchester, or continue that as I'm doing now, where I work both at the University of Manchester and at the Tata Medical Center in Kolkata. I was encouraged to do the latter by my seniors at the university, and they said, you are going to need support and you're also going to be need a lot of interactions, and the University of Manchester can support you in this. So I went with the experience, I have 25 years of experience as a pediatric oncologist, but I had now learned how to set up a laboratory, how to set up actually a research institute, and all that has actually been that 6 years of working in the University of Manchester before I went to India.
The aim of this program is to ask people who are internationally known to bring back their skills and their laboratory to India so that people from India can benefit.
The university has a large team of people working on very similar problems, and the challenge was then to say, okay, we've got this knowledge, we've acquired this knowledge, can we apply it somewhere else? And that was the challenge of India. With the training I've received in the United Kingdom, the experience at the University of Manchester and running such programs, it kind of looked to me that I was the guy who should take this challenge up. And if I didn't take it up, then who was going to take it up?
The Magdarshi Fellowship is our highest fellowship. And Vaskar was our first Magdarshi Fellow. Our overall vision is to really support the best people who do biomedical research in India. But it's not just giving them funds to do research, it's also to develop the next generation of science leaders in the country.
So when the child comes here with his parents and looks at our hospital, it's actually quite daunting for a new person coming from a village to even see the structure and say, my God, what am I going to do here?
So let's take that family, right? The family has shown up from some remote village. They want to know that their kid is going to come out surviving. And to know that worldwide the standard is 80 to 95%, it's almost unethical to say, why should we be exposing them to treatment, or which is maybe still at 40 or 50%? And yet there are challenges of countries like ours. Why have we not been able to get there?
So one of the things that people say is that the cost of treatment, you know, the therapy is expensive, cancer is expensive, and families can't afford them. That is actually not true. That's what I found out here. Most hospitals will subsidize therapy for poor patients. There are a number of governmental organizations and non-governmental organizations that actually make therapy absolutely quite affordable. But what it doesn't take care of is the fact that patients in India, and I guess worldwide, will travel to where they think is the best place for care for their family and their children.
Many of these families actually come from remote places, from small places, from villages. They've come to the cities to get their child treated. And sometimes they're spending 3 years at a place far away from home.
প্রথমে আমরা ভাবিনি এই রোগটা সম্পর্কে আমাদের আইডিয়াই ছিল না যে হোয়াট ইজ ক্যান্সার বাট আমরা যখন এই রোগটা সম্পর্কে জানলাম তখন মনে হলো যে জীবনের সমস্ত কিছু তছনছ হয়ে গেছে
তা আমি কারো মুখ থেকে টাটা মেডিকেল সম্পর্কে একটু জানতে পেরে আমি এখানে আসি কারণ আমার আর্থিক অবস্থা খুবই খারাপ ছিল আমি একটা ছোটোখাটো মানে আর কি ডায়াক্টিনের আমার একটা ব্যবসা ছিল সেখান থেকে আমি কী করবো আমি নিজে বুঝে উঠতে পারছিলাম না
আমরা যখন ট্রিটমেন্টটা শুরু করি তো তখন আমাদের যাই হোক আমরা পয়সার তো কোনো মতে আমরা মানে প্রয়োজনে কোথা থেকে আনবো কী আনবো কোনো কিছুই মাথায় আসছিল না রুলস আছে যার জন্য আমরা কিছু হেল্প পেতে পারি তো আমরা তাদের সঙ্গে গিয়ে আমরা কথা বলি তো সেখান থেকে আমরা ম্যাডামদের কাছ থেকে প্রচুর মানে যেটুকু হোক আমরা মোটামুটি হেল্প পাই যার জন্য আমরা ট্রিটমেন্টটাকে আরও সুস্থ সচল করতে পারি
I have the world's most wonderful job because what do? I take the family's most precious possession, I restore this child back to the bosom of their family in perfect health, but I return that family back to poverty for a whole generation. And that's really a challenge we've got. If you talk to the parents, they will say that they've had to sell assets, they've had to borrow money, and usually from the local community, and we have this sort of tongue-in-cheek saying that it takes a whole village to treat one child with leukemia. Because that's the kind of support. And what we're trying to do here is to make the therapy much more systematic, make it uniform, and decrease this entire cost and burden and this lottery of treatment.
He has catalyzed change for leukemia. So even those who are not following the same protocol are moving up the game for better standard, for better treatment, for better care. But the fact of the matter is that we have maybe 80,000 new cases of childhood cancer in the country. So we can't have 80,000 children going to the few centers that can offer the best standard of care. So what we need is protocols and standards where even the smaller centers can benefit. And I think that is what is happening with the Icicle study and the Icicle protocol, because many other smaller centers are picking it up.
We talk about the living bridge between India and Britain, the flow of people, ideas, technologies, and certainly this example of the University of Manchester working with the Tata Medical Center is one of the best examples I know of. And so, for example, if you have illnesses emerging in this part of the world, you can bring the technology of the world to the doorstep here to treat it.
Science is global, health is global, problems are global. And solutions to problems in India may come from Manchester, or solutions to problems in Manchester may come from India. So therefore, I think it's very important for people to collaborate across boundaries, across international borders.
It's about equity, and it's about making an impact. And I think that in some small way, the work in India reflects then a distillation of everything I've learned in Manchester. So this is not my own wisdom. This collective wisdom, a collective effort, I just happen to front it. And we have benefited many thousands of children.
তো যাই হোক এখন 2 years প্রায় কাছাকাছি চলে এসেছে তো আমার ছেলে এখন সুস্থ আছে এবং ম্যাডামরা যেভাবে ডক্টররা যেভাবে আমাদেরকে হেল্প করেছে যার জন্য আমরা এই জায়গাটায় পৌঁছাতে পেরেছি এবং এখনও পর্যন্ত আমার ছেলে সুস্থ আছে এবং আশা করি তাদের কথাতে এবং আমাদের বিশ্বাসও আরও সুস্থ হয়ে উঠবে।
ক্যান্সারের এই রিসার্চগুলো পরবর্তী দিনে আরও ভালো হয়ে যাবে, অনেক মানুষ আসবে যাবে, কিন্তু এখানে তাতে পরবর্তীকালে আমাদের যেমন এতটা সময় লাগছে তাদের অত সময় লাগবে না।
What is the purpose of learning? And the purpose of learning is to benefit other people and to pass it on. Universities like internationally ranked universities like University of Manchester owe it to society. We are funded by society. We have to turn it back to society. And this is a larger global society. We're no longer a small island. We're part of a large world. And we owe it to the world to say that we have done this and we can benefit everybody on this planet.